To install a waste valve, follow these simple steps. The T&S B-3990 modular waste drain valves fit sinks with a 3.5-inch drain opening and are available in a variety of configurations. No matter which options you choose, the B-3990 line is easy to install and maintain. Before you get started, be sure you have the following tools. All T&S waste drain valves come pre-assembled to ensure no vital parts are lost during the shipping process or during transport to the installation site. To begin installation, start by removing the snap-in strainer and unscrew the sink flange assembly from the waste drain assembly. Next, apply a bead of plumber's putty to the bottom of the sink flange assembly where it contacts the sink bowl. For safety, keep the drain guard installed in the sink flange assembly at all times. Next, be sure the underside and inside mating surfaces around the drain of the sink bowl are clean. This will help ensure a tight, secure fit. Now, place the gasket and waste drain assembly below the sink, aligning with the sink drain opening. Screw the sink flange assembly into the waste drain assembly, accessing both through the sink drain opening. Before tightening, position the waste drain handle in the desired location. Then tighten the sink flange assembly with the tool provided. Now connect the drain line to the waste drain outlet. If outlet adapters are used, seal all threaded connections with pipe sealant. Finally, open and close the waste drain several times to check for proper operation, then check for any potential leaks. For waste drain valves using an overflow head, simply follow these additional installation steps. The modular design of the waste drain valve will allow for the overflow port on the outlet to be positioned to the left, back, or right. If you wish to change the position of the overflow head, follow these four steps. If not, skip to step 5. Remove the four cap screws with a 5/32 hex key wrench and rotate the outlet to the desired position. If the outlet has been removed, be sure the valve seal is either in the valve body or installed correctly on the outlet lip. Replace the four cap screws and tighten. Install the overflow head on the sink. Next, measure and cut the overflow tube to fit into the overflow head and the port on the waste drain outlet. Finally, install the coupling nuts and seals on the overflow tube. Then install the tube and tighten all connections. Under normal operation, the most likely failure area for leaks is the valve body assembly, often due to worn valve body seals. Before beginning, be sure you have the following tools on hand. If you see a leak with a handle open, the entire valve body assembly will need to be replaced. You'll need a replacement assembly, which comes with two valve body seals. If the valve leaks when closed, only the seals need to be replaced. These are available as part of the valve body seal kit. Fixing the leak takes just a few simple steps. First, if an overflow head is installed, loosen the tube connection at the port on the outlet of the waste drain. If an overflow head is not installed, begin by using pliers to loosen the two support rods attached to the ends of the handle. Then unscrew by hand. After that, unscrew the handle from the middle rod. Next, remove the four cap screws that attach the outlet to the waste drain assembly. Then pull the outlet free. The valve body assembly, including the handle, will pull clear of the waste drain once enough separation of the parts has occurred. Now you can remove the valve body seals, which may be in the assembly itself or stuck on the lips of the drain bell or outlet. If you're just replacing the valve body seals, install the new seals and ensure a tight fit. It's best to install the seals on the lips of the drain bell and outlet rather than inside the assembly. If you're replacing the entire assembly, simply unscrew the handle from the old assembly and screw it onto the new one. Finally, reassemble as indicated before. Note that the valve body assembly should be installed with the T&S logo visible from below. If your B-3990 waste drain valve is clogged, first try clearing the drain lines through the cleanout ports in the drain system. If the clog remains, follow these simple steps to clear it through the waste drain passage. Before you get started, be sure you have the following tools. First, close the waste drain valve to prevent losing loose objects. Then, remove the snap-in strainer. Next, remove the drain guard by loosening the two vandal-resistant screws using the spanner bit provided. Note that the screws only need to be loosened, not removed completely. Now rotate the drain guard so the screws align with the notches in the flange, then lift out the drain guard. For your own safety, you should never put your hands or fingers in the drain passage when the drain guard is removed. Finally, open the waste drain to clear the drain line as needed. Then close the waste drain and reinstall the drain guard. And snap-in strainer.